All right, we have a special something that we're going to do during worship in 2024. As many of you know, we joined the Global Methodist Church last year, and the Global Methodist Church has something called a catechism. Catechism is just a fancy word for here are the things that we believe. So I thought it would be very helpful for us to actually walk through one of those things every single week. Now, a catechism also is an easy way for children and adults to be able to learn theology. All right, so every week we're going to do the catechism question as a part of worship, and the children are going to do the same question, and it's going to be child-sized. All right, so those of you that are parents, you may say, well, it may look a little bit different. You'll see their copy, and you'll be able to have your copy. All right, if you're not a parent, I'm expecting you to learn it too. All right, so we have come up with a new Covenant Catechism app. All right, I know you're excited, aren't you? A new app for your phone. All right, so that you can actually download it, and then we'll walk through. You just have to slide, and it goes from the question to the answer. All right, so if you go to the App Store, the Apple App Store, you can find it at Covenant Church GMC Catechism, and it will come right up. If you're using an inferior product, my understanding is that it takes Google a week or two to catch up. So it's not available this weekend, but hopefully it will be this week. You can also go to our website. So anyway, on my phone, I actually have it here under my Covenant app, and I'm just going to click on it, and then it comes right up to the first question. All right, so I'm making a commitment. I'm going to do this at my wife and I will do this at our house so that we can be able to speak through the catechism. All right, so today we're going to do question number one, and I did this last night, and they did very well. Saturday night did very well. I said, when we get to the part of the service where we say, now it's time for our catechism question, your response should be, woo! That's right. All right, that was not as good as last night. All right, because some of you were not as excited. So next week, I'm sure that you will be. All right, so this is the first question in the catechism. Do you believe in God? Well, the answer should be yes, but it's actually more than that. So we're going to read it together. Let's show the answer. Yes, ready? I believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and all that is seen and unseen. All right, now, why do you learn something like this? Because someone's going to ask you, do you believe in God? And you can say, well, yes, and here's what I believe. And we'll walk through one question every week. So I'm looking forward to this. Make sure you download the app to your phone, and then you can work on it during the week. When you're just sitting at the stoplight, you can say, what was that catechism question? All right, very good. Well, Happy New Year to all of you as we begin today. And let me welcome everybody at our Washington campus. And today, for the very first time, we are welcoming our ministry partner down in Sampson County, Keener Methodist Church. Let's welcome them. All right. All right, we're excited to have your church, your folks, as a part of Covenant Church, as a partnership church, and we'll look forward to being able to work with you. There is something that is a little bit exciting about the new year. There's something, I don't say hopeful. It's like when, it's no different. It's just kind of like last week, but last week was last year, this week is this year, and now we feel like it's a fresh year. It's like you get a fresh start, and from what I can tell, a lot of us need a fresh start. So as we begin 2024, I want to encourage you to come back every single week expecting something. I mean, that means before you even get here, you're anticipating that God has a word for you for this year. And so something new to say just to you. All right, I do believe that when you're anticipating that God is going to speak, then you're looking for it. You're digging into it. You're saying, you know, I really do have some hope for this year. So anyway, just thinking about that gets me excited. So today we're going to begin this new year in the Old Testament, in the book of 1 Chronicles. Aren't you excited about that? All right, somebody's already thinking, can anything new or good come out of the book of 1 Chronicles? And the answer is yes. You know, in the midst of a chapter of what is seemingly endless genealogies, and I know you've read genealogies in the Bible before, and a lot of times we skip over them because a lot of those are names that we can't even pronounce, but in the midst of a chapter of genealogies, there is a gem of a prayer by a man named Jabez. Jabez. Now, several years ago, a man by the name of Bruce Wilkinson wrote a book, and he the whole material, the whole text of the book is on this one little prayer in the book of Chronicles. You may have read the book that he wrote. 9 million people have bought the book. So it must be something. And so whether you've heard of it or not, whether this is, you know, Jabez, that name is new or not, it's a really great way to start a new year. And so that's what we're going to do today. So Jabez's story starts in 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 9. It says, his mother named him Jabez, saying, I gave birth to him in pain. Now, did you hear that? It says, she named him Jabez because she was in pain. Or his name, the name Jabez, it means pain. I mean, what in the world was this woman thinking? Naming her sweet little baby Pain. I mean, that's the kind of name that could follow you around all your life. Everybody's going to know your name is Pain. I mean, what a terrible name. Now, maybe she had a really painful childbirth. Some of your mamas could have named you Pain, right? Maybe her husband had died. Maybe he'd gotten killed somehow. Maybe he got sick or he died in a war or something. And so, you know, they had a wonderful family, and then by the time Jabez came, she was going to have to raise him and his brothers as a single mother. You know, it doesn't say. It just says she named him Jabez. Again, she names him Pain. And for the rest of his life, he is going to carry around that name. I mean, talk about self-esteem issues. I mean, has anybody ever heard of someone named Jabez? I mean, you know why now, don't you? I mean, no one would want to do that to their child. Not that some of us hadn't of don't think about our name sometime being Jabez. We look at our circumstances, or we see, boy, I've been through the ringer I mean, your name may not be that, but you think about yourself that way. Well, you know, I've got really good news today. In this little short message, what it says is our circumstances do not have to define us. And our situation doesn't have to be the last word. Because this man Jabez, and by the way, his name means, I've got a miserable life. He is not known for his circumstances. In fact, we don't really know his circumstances. He's known for the prayer that he prayed. And here's the prayer that he prayed. It's in verse 10. Jabez cried out to God, to the God of Israel, "Oh, that you would bless me and enlarge my territory. Let your hand be with me and keep me from harm so that I will be free from pain." That's it. Short and sweet, but very significant. And it's divided, it can be divided into four little bitty statements that he makes in this prayer. And I thought it would be helpful for us to look at them individually. And so the first one that he prays, first thing he says is, "Oh, that you would bless me. Lord, bless me." Now, this is not the same thing that a lot of people pray, because I think a lot of people just pray in kind of a general, "Lord, bless me." This is a different kind of prayer than that. It is a prayer of desperation. What he is praying here is, "Lord, if you don't intervene in my situation, if you don't reverse the trends of my life, then I'm going to have to continue in this painful mess that I'm living in for the rest of my life. So I am throwing myself on your mercy. I need your help. I don't want my life to continue the way it's been going. I need a blessing, not a curse. I need a blessing from you." You know, that word blessing simply means supernatural outpouring, supernatural favor injected into your current circumstances. And so here's how I would translate that prayer. I would translate it like this: I need some supernatural favor in my life. I need some supernatural favor from you, Lord. Now, when you pray that, what you're saying is, "Lord, I am serious, and I'm serious enough to invite you to come into my life and be in my business. I am desperate enough to ask you to intervene in my situation. You know, you see where I am." In other words, you're saying to the Lord, "I want a different life than what I've got right now. I don't like the life I'm living right now. And so I need something different. Right now I'm in a painful situation. But Lord, I'm asking that you would do something. I need an impartation of supernatural in the midst of my natural life." And I think it's interesting. Did you notice that Jabez doesn't tell God how to bless him? He doesn't give any specifics. He just says, "Lord, I need your favor in my life." Because the truth is, when you're in pain, you'll take whatever God will give you, won't you? Knowing that He has your best interest in mind. So, you know, I just wonder today, anybody here need some supernatural favor in your situation? I mean, anybody here would say, "You know what, I could use a blessing. in my life. Now, if you were to say, well, sure, I could use a little blessing. Well, then you're not praying the Jabez prayer, because that's not what he prays. He's not saying, yeah, I'll take a little bit. No, he's basically taking an empty cup, and he's saying, Lord, this is my life, and I got nothing. I'm in a mess. I don't like where I am, and I'm asking if you'll pour out any favor possible, because if you don't do something, nothing in my life is going to change. And so he says, Lord, would you bless me? Then he goes on, and he says, and enlarge my territory, which seems like a land grab to me, doesn't it? You know what? I own an acre now. Would you give me 10 acres? Or I've got a small house and need a bigger house. It seems like a selfish kind of prayer, but I don't think that is what Jabez is praying here. I think this is just a continuation of his dissatisfaction with his current circumstances. I think he's saying, Lord, you see where I am right now, and I'm asking you to expand my capacities. I'm asking you to expand the opportunities that I have so that I can do more with my life for you. Now listen, that's a pretty good prayer, isn't it? Lord, would you give me more opportunities so I can do more for you? He says, Lord, I want you to help me see things from a different perspective. I want you to help me see things I've never seen before. I want you to help me do things I've never done before. Now, I want you to expand my territory, because I believe if you invade my life, you can take my current circumstances and you can make them great. Now, here's my translation of what he's saying here. He says, I need some increased capacity so I can serve you more. Don't miss the last part. So I can serve you more. Now, by the way, you can't ever pray that kind of prayer. Lord, I want more if you're satisfied with what you've got right now. Because if you're fine where you are, you ought to just stop with the blessing prayer. All right, Lord, bless me. All right, I could use a little favor, but I'm good. I got no bigger dreams. I'm fine right where I am. But listen, if you're not fine with where you are, you believe that there's more and that God could open up doors and can do some incredible things, then you start saying, Lord, would you expand my capacity? You know, that's what Jabez is praying here. He says, I am tired of being defined by this name, being defined by misery. I'm tired of being a victim of my circumstances. Lord, I want you to open up my life, and I want you to take me to higher heights and deeper depths and broader horizons. Lord, I want you to expand my capacity. You know, anybody here dare pray that prayer this year? Anybody just already thinking, I wonder if there is more than there was last year for me? I wonder if there's greater. Now, again, most people never pray this prayer. They never ask God, and so they never see anything bigger because they're perfectly satisfied with where they are. Yet, he is saying the potential, Lord, is so great. Would you expand my territory? Then he's still not finished. And he says, and will you let your hand be with me? Will you let your hand be on me? And don't miss this. This is a pretty important lesson, I think. The reason that he says this He's not just saying, bless me and continue to bless me. No, he says, no, I want your hand with me, because there is a potential pitfall with every blessing and with every expansion of territory, that God will bless us and we'll receive the blessing and then we'll forget who he is. And we'll forget he's the one who gave us the blessing in the first place. And so here's what Jabez prays. He says, Lord, I want you to bless me. And I want you to enlarge my frontiers. But I don't want any blessing that doesn't come with you as a part of the package. Okay, if you're not going to be a part of it, then I don't even want the blessing. The translation. My translation is, I don't want any blessing without the Lord with me. I don't want any blessing that the Lord is not a part of. Yeah, I love what Moses says to God. God calls him to an incredible task. He says, I want you to go to the Pharaoh of Egypt and tell him to let my people go. And Moses says, I will do it. I will go. But I'm not going unless you go with me. I mean, I appreciate the confidence in my leadership. I appreciate this incredible assignment. But if you're not going with me, I'm not going. Because unless your hand is upon me, I don't want the blessing. Now you think about that. Think about how many things are supposed to be a blessing in our life, and they turn out not to be a blessing. You know, I made more money, and now I'm more miserable. You know, I've got a big house. It just doesn't seem like there's a lot of love in that house. I've got this great position, but I'm not excited about the work. Sometimes a blessing without the Lord ends up not being a blessing at all. Look what it says in Proverbs 10. It says, the blessing of the Lord makes a person rich, and he adds no sorrow with it. In other words, you know when something is a blessing when there is joy in it for you. You know, when there's no joy, it's like, well, maybe I have received something good, but I've left the Lord behind. Not Jabez. Jabez says, look, I want the blessing. I want the expansion. But I want to keep my dependence on you no matter what, because I need you. So keep your hand on me. And then he prays one last thing. He says, and keep me from harm, so that I will not be in pain. Keep me from harm. Now, there's a reason that he prays this. And again, it's not the normal reason that most people pray this. And can I just be honest? Most people's, the entirety of their prayer life is, Lord, keep me safe. Keep me safe while I'm driving. Keep me safe while I'm at home. Keep me safe while I'm at work. Keep me safe while I'm traveling. Just keep me safe. That is not what he's praying here, by the way. That's not Jabez's style. Because listen, he's already prayed in utter desperation. Lord, I need supernatural favor in my life, or I'm sunk. I'm going to live the same life that I've been living. That's not a safe prayer. Then he has said, and Lord, I want more than I have been able to see in the past. I want you to open up the borders to me. And again, that's not a safe prayer. Then he has said, and Lord, I want to walk with you closely all the days of my life. And listen, you start praying like that, you start praying risky, bold, courageous prayers like that, and I'm going to tell you, you become known as dangerous to the other side. Okay, God loves those prayers, but you become a threat to the devil when you start praying like that. And so Jabez is wise. He says, listen, I don't want the flow of blessing to be thwarted in my life. I do want a new and exciting life, but as I do, I know that I need you to guard my heart. I need you to guard my mind. I need you to guard my steps, because I know that the devil's coming after me. Because if you're blessing, he's not happy. So he's, and I know he'll try to get me to use these blessings for myself and forget all about you. He'll try to get me to praise me, give myself the credit rather than give you the credit. And I don't want any of those things. I don't want there to be anything that's going to come between me and you because of these blessings. So protect me from everything that Satan might throw at me. So again, my translation is, I need some protection because I know I will be in a battle. I know that the devil is going to come after me if you're blessing me. Now, by the way, let me just say this. If the devil's not messing with you now, that just means one thing. You're no threat. You're no threat to him at all. And you know, the truth is, a lot of us are messing up our life on our own just fine. He doesn't need to come in and do anything. You know, we're doing just fine. He doesn't need to intervene. But look, you start praying a prayer like this. Lord, bless me. Expand my territory. Lord, keep your hand on me and keep the devil off my back. You're going to need God to protect you. And that's what he prays. That's what Jabez prays. Lord, you know, keep the devil away from me. This is basically the Old Testament version of the Lord's Prayer, isn't it? And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. And so this is what Jabez prays. And look at the result. It's such a simple result. It says, and God granted his request. He called on the Lord. The Lord heard his prayer. The Lord saw his desperation. He got his answers because he asked. Because it says he cried out to the Lord. He was just desperate enough because he's been in pain, because he wasn't satisfied with his life, because he knew there was more, because he needed the Lord's help to call on him and say, I don't want the same old life. I need you to intervene. And it says, and the Lord intervened. So let me ask. What would it be like if every one of us were to start this year with Jabez's prayer? That, you know, Jabez would be okay if we steal his prayer. It's a good prayer. I mean, I just wonder, what would it be like if we were to wake up every day and say, Lord, I need your favor in my life today. I want you to open up what I've never even dreamed of. Would you do that? Would you stay close to me? I want to be closer to you this year than I was last year. And Lord, protect me as I walk through this year. Walk with me every step of the way. What would it be like if we started our year like that? Be incredible. I want to encourage you to do that. Here's how you do it. You take your sermon notes and you put them somewhere that you will see this prayer. Means you pin it up to a mirror, you put it on a bulletin board, you put it on the refrigerator, you put it somewhere that you will see it so that you'll be reminded again and again. There's that prayer of Jabez. All right? Now, some of you are thinking, well, Oh, golly, I didn't take any notes. Shame on you. All right? So if you didn't do it, it's okay. You can go to our Covenant app, and you can download the message notes this week, and you can print them out for yourself. Okay, because here's the deal. If right now you're like, well, that's a pretty cool prayer. I think I could pray that. But when in about an hour, you'll forget what we even talked about. So you need to give yourself a reminder, print it out, put it where you can see it, or next year, you'll come back here, and you'll be in the same place you are now. You will have the same territory you have now. You'll be in the same pain you are now. You'll have the same old life that you have right now. Or maybe, if you take the challenge, next year at this time, you'll go, let me tell you what the Lord did in my life. Let me tell you about His favor, how He opened up the life, how He walked with me closely. It was amazing. So it's up to you. So Lord, thank You for this incredible prayer. Thank You that You answered Jabez's prayer. And Lord, I thank You that when we ask You to come into our lives, when we pray a prayer, we cry out in desperation and need, You come right along with us. You love to answer that prayer. So, Lord, would You do some things that in our lives this year that we didn't even know was possible, that we had no idea that You could do. Open up opportunities, enlarge relationships and capacities to be able to do ministry so that we might come back in a year and give You praise for all that You've done. And we thank You in Jesus' name. Amen.